As I mentioned, Arduino is not only used in the artmail context, but can also be utilized across various hardware platforms. Among these, there are Arduino-specific APIs and commands. Aside from those commands, it's just like any regular C or C++ project. So, here, I will show you how to add the desired header files or source code files while writing the code. First, let's assume that I will input the code to make the LED blink. First, you need to set the device as the output. This is an important step to ensure that the device functions correctly. Once you have done that, the next step is to turn it off. This might seem counterintuitive, but it is necessary for the following steps. After turning it off, you can proceed to set it up in the desired manner. For instance, you can configure it to operate in a specific mode or adjust its settings to suit your needs. Now, I will demonstrate how to set the blinking delay. This is done by defining a macro constant, which in this case will be set to 0.5 seconds. This means that the device will blink at intervals of half a second, providing a clear and consistent signal. You can set it up like this. When setting values like this, if there are many macro constants being used, you can organize them in another header file and reference them in the main code. This approach helps in keeping the main code clean and more manageable. In my case, I press the new tab button here and enter the file name below, then check settings. Header. From there, you can copy the macro constants directly and input them here. This way, you can organize the code more neatly and efficiently. As a reference, I will create a function for this. I will call it the blink function, so that instead of just inputting values, I can make it more flexible by adding variables. The blink function will allow for more dynamic control over the values, making the code more adaptable to different scenarios. For example, if you need to change the blink rate, you can simply adjust the variable rather than hard coding the value. This method not only saves time, but also reduces the risk of errors. Additionally, organizing macro constants in a separate header file makes it easier to maintain and update the code. If any changes are needed, you only have to update the header file, and the changes will be reflected throughout the main code. This practice is particularly useful in large projects where multiple files and constants are involved. By keeping the code organized and modular, you can improve readability and maintainability, which are crucial for long-term project success. First, I created a function called blink that makes the LED blink as many times as the variable you input. For example, it blinks 5 times, waits for about approximately 3 seconds, and successfully compiles without errors. This is how I created this particular function in detail. However, if you are dealing with hardware components such as an LED light, a motor device, and a switch, all within one Arduino project, I prefer not to clutter up the main code with everything all together. Instead, I break it down into separate libraries for better organization. The actual code for controlling each specific piece of hardware is contained within those individual libraries, while only what is necessary for initialization purposes and commands to control said hardware remains in the main code itself. For instance, in case of handling an LED specifically, I would create a separate dedicated library just for LEDs. Let me show you exactly how it's done step by step. First off, I'll create an initial header file specifically tailored towards managing our LED component, and then proceed from there. This is now a header for the library, which means it serves as a crucial part of the library's structure and functionality. A header file in a library is essential because it defines the interface to the library's functionality, making it easier for other parts of the program to interact with the library. Therefore, I will input it as macro constants, which are essentially predefined values that can be used throughout the code to ensure consistency and ease of maintenance. Macro constants are beneficial because they allow for easy updates and changes. If a value needs to be modified, it can be done in one place rather than throughout the entire code base. Since Arduino is based on C++, a language that supports object-oriented programming and other advanced features, I will also input these macro constants. However, I will do it in C code, which is a procedural programming language that is simpler and more straightforward for this purpose. Using C code for macro constants can be advantageous because it provides better control over the hardware and can lead to more efficient code execution. Similarly, I will prefer to do it this way because it allows for better control and understanding of the code. Earlier, I provided these macro constants here, but I will remove them and name them LEDPIN, then LEDBLINK, and then LEDNIP, and so on. This naming convention helps in clearly identifying the purpose of each constant, making the code more readable and easier to debug. By organizing the constants in this manner, we can ensure that the code remains clean and efficient, which is essential for the smooth operation of the library. Clean and efficient code is crucial because it reduces the likelihood of errors, makes the code base easier to maintain, and improves overall performance. So, having created the header for our project, let's take a moment to first remove the existing settings that are currently in place. After that, we will proceed to make the LED header appear on the screen. This step is crucial as it ensures that the LED header is properly displayed and functions correctly. Now, if you click the right tab over here, there is a delete option. Press the delete key to remove the settings header file that was just added to your project. After you have done that, click here to open a new tab which will contain the LEDC file. In addition to the LEDC file, you will also find the LED header file and the include Arduino header file here. Make sure to include the Arduino header for the LED header now. This step is crucial for the proper functioning of the LED header file. By following these steps, you ensure that all necessary files are correctly added and configured in your project. Remember, the order of these actions is important to avoid any potential issues. To simply call Arduino commands here, you need to add the Arduino header file. In my particular case, as I had done earlier in the process, once everything is meticulously organized and set up in this specific manner, we will proceed to have the LED blink here. The LED should blink exactly 5 times, no more and no less. However, during my attempt, I encountered a compilation error. The error message stated UINT8T unknown type. This error typically occurs when the compiler does not recognize the UINT8T type, which is supposed to represent an unsigned 8-bit integer. This type is often used in embedded systems programming to ensure that variables use a specific amount of memory. The issue might be due to a missing library or an incorrect include statement in the code. To resolve this, one would need to ensure that the correct header files are included, such as stdint, H, which defines UINT8T. Additionally, it is important to check the compiler settings and make sure that it supports the C standard that includes this type definition. This kind of error can be quite common when working with different compilers or when porting code from one environment to another. It is always a good practice to double-check the documentation and ensure that all dependencies are correctly referenced in the project setup. By addressing these potential issues, the compilation error can be resolved, allowing the LED to blink as intended. Then, the code has been cleaned up here. In the main code, we include the LED library and the LED header. Then, we only execute the initialization related to that library during the initial setup. However, if you look at the code file, you'll see that we set the LED pin output. Turn it off once, And then in the actual operation part, we simply call the commands. In reality, the LED code file handles the repetition based on the count, turning it on and off. Additionally, the macro constants are managed separately in the header file. This is how the code is structured. This time, we explored adding files in the Arduino IDE. As I mentioned earlier, aside from the basic Arduino API and Arduino commands, the rest is the same as a typical C and C++ project. It's just that adding headers and using source code is the same, even though it might be slightly different from the Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio, or other C editors you are already using. In the next session, I will further explain how to create libraries. Then, I will see you next time.